John the Baptist said to the Pharisees who came to be baptized to bear fruit worthy of repentance before getting baptized. Many people believe that baptism proves someone's repentance, and this is because of the false teachings of many teachers of the Bible, who are only interested to win more followers, who then become twice as sons of hell as their teachers are. Acts chapter 10 is a clear example how real repentance looks. It's written Cornelius the centurion, a non-Israelite, was a devout man who feared God, gave alms generously, and always prayed. Verse 30 says he was fasting. I want to read verses 34 and 35 because they are very important. Apostle Peter, who was guided by the Holy Spirit, says this: "Then Peter opened his mouth and said, 'In truth, I perceive that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, whoever fears him and works righteousness is accepted by him.'" We notice here that God is perceiving all the nations in the world equal to one another. And it's very clear that only those who fear God and work righteousness are accepted by him. God does not tolerate sin. Do not be deceived. One cannot walk in the ways of this world, be in bondage to sin, and think that through baptism they can flee or escape the wrath to come. John the Baptist calls these people brood of vipers. Cornelius and all his household were baptized with the Holy Spirit first because they heard the words of Peter, who preached to them Jesus Christ. And John indeed baptizes with water, but Jesus Christ baptizes with the Holy Spirit. Water baptism without repentance is pointless. The kingdom of God is not about playing in the water. It's about seeking the kingdom of God and his righteousness above all. And then God will find a way for us to be baptized, just like he did with Cornelius. But we must make sure we are accepted by God first. And after baptism, we must abide in him and endure until the end to receive eternal life. Cornelius feared God. He gave alms generously. He always prayed. He was fasting. He was basically seeking the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Dear friends, without holiness, no man shall see God. We must strive to enter through the narrow gate, because many will try and will not be able to. Trying is not good enough. We must strive to find the kingdom of God and his righteousness. Jews or Gentiles, whoever wants to be accepted by God must fear him and work righteousness. Seek Jesus with faith. May Jesus bless you.